Our drama on the history of Mauritius is about to begin. But first of all, I'd like to say a few words. Our intention with this theatrical piece is not to offend or confuse anyone. This is indeed a tribute to our ancestors, reliving the joy, their sorrow, stamina, and resilience to make us what we are today. I don't know how many in the audience also feel this way. While growing up in both Mauritius and Australia, we learned and studied the history of many other countries, but seem to neglect the history of our own. The drama we are about to witness will take us on a journey back in time and relive some of the events that gave rise to the emergence of our own unique race. Ladies and gentlemen, sit back and enjoy the show.
This is the story of Mauritius, known as the Paradise Island. The first people to set foot on the island were Arab sailors and merchants. The island was at the time known as Dinarubin. Arab merchant ships have been sailing the Indian Ocean for centuries. In 1498, the Portuguese explorer Vasco da Gama succeeded in rounding the Cape of Good Hope. The group of islands consisting of Mauritius, Seychelles, Réunion, Rodrigues, and other islands were given the names of Mascarenes after the Portuguese captain Pero Mascarenhas. In 1598, Dutch Vice Admiral Van Warwick came ashore and gave the island the name of Mauritius after the Dutch ruler Maurice van de Nassau. The Dutch introduced sugarcane on the island, but also were responsible for the extinction of the dodo. Most significantly, the Dutch introduced slavery in Mauritius. For our ancestors began in 1638 on Paradise Island, Mauritius. The slaves were made to build Fort Frederick Hendrick, a square wooden fort with bastions and cannons at each corner, which still stands today in Vieux Grand Port as a symbol of supremacy of the Dutch in the Indian Ocean. The slaves worked the sugarcane fields, and ebony forests worked for the Dutch. This made the Dutch one of the biggest traders of ebony in the region. The slaves were constantly tortured and humiliated, but these first blood slaves still had vivid memories of their mother Africa, which gave them the power to overcome the Dutch, burning down the symbolic fort. The Dutch finally left the island, leaving the slaves behind.
Come on!
After 72 years of agony, the slaves had their first taste of freedom, enabling them to go back to their traditional African ways and practice the traditional ceremony of the pile. Little did they know that this would only last for the next 5 years, and the nightmare that once was would become a horrific reality once more. shelter at the heights of a mountain, the Ormond Grabo that sits next to the sea. The French columns from Bourbon Island would always be actively on the trail of the escaped slaves. The treatment reserved for those slaves that were captured was horrific. It is not until 1721 that the French settlement expanded. One of the most important chapters of the history of Ile-de-France was written under the leadership of Governor Mahé de la Boudinie. Port Louis was established as a naval base and a shipbuilding centre.
Mes chers amis, je désire vous apprendre que le roi de France m'a donné un brevet de gouverneur général des Mascareignes. Ce qui fait que l'île Bourbon et l'île Maurice sera sous mon administration. Aujourd'hui, je désigne le port nord-ouest comme le chef-lieu de l'île de France. Comme vous le savez, l'île a été une possession française depuis 1715 et ce n'est pas pour dénigrer l'ancien administrateur, M. de Cossigny, mais je constate que l'île est restée dans un état vierge, tel que la nature l'avait formée. Mes amis, je vous le dis, cette île a de gros atouts. Prenons ce port nord-ouest. Nous pouvons radouber des bateaux. Il n'y a pas lieu pour moi de vous le dire. La route des épices est une mine d'or. Alors, il nous faut faire de ce port le premier entrepôt de la route des Indes. Bientôt, je vais écrire à la Compagnie des Indes pour les faire savoir mes projets. Dans ma lettre, je mentionnerai le développement du port. Pour cela, je compte faire venir de l'Inde des matelots indigènes connus sous le nom de Lascar. La navigation est un projet primordial. Aussi, il nous faut guider les navigateurs pendant la nuit. Alors, je vais établir un poste de quelques hommes sur le morne de la découverte. Ils vont entretenir un feu destiné à la navigation nocturne. Il nous faut des routes afin d'exploiter l'île. Aussi, je pense construire des routes menant à Mocha, Pamplemousse et le port Bourbon. Je compte faire venir des bœufs de Madagascar et fabriquer de la chaux. Mes amis, je dois vous dire qu'après le port, il nous faut donner priorité à la construction d'un hôpital, puis faire venir l'eau potable de la grande rivière au moyen d'un aqueduc. J'espère élever bientôt des magasins, des logements pour les officiers, construire des bateaux. J'ai même en tête la construction de l'hôtel du gouvernement. fortifier l'île, surtout au Codan, et sur l'île au Tonnelier, où nous placerons des batteries. Et en dernier lieu, une grande caserne où nous renfermerons ces messieurs les Anglais et tout autre récalcitrant. Messieurs, faisons de façon d'être dignes d'être français et saluons le drapeau fleur de lysée.
Of slaves from numerous parts of the world were stolen, shipped, and offloaded in Port Louis. They arrived on shore, beaten, and the women brutally raped.
like to thank a few people. Please, cast, don't leave. We'd like to thank you. Stay.
They deserve another round of applause, I think, there. Yes. They were fantastic, you guys. So we will start by thanking a lot of people. A lot of people have put in a lot of effort to have this play on tonight, and they had fantastic costumes and a fantastic script. So first of all, we would like to ask Marie-Rose to come forward, please. Marie-Rose Caloux did all the costumes for the soldiers, for the slaves, and for the sailors. I think she needs to hear me draw your applause.
We call on Veronique Samachetti. Would you step forward, please? Veronique, where are you?
She's been hiding.
Veronique did the narration of the drama. She put a lot of effort into traveling all the way to Hampton Park on a number of traveling to Glenroy, sorry, on a number of occasions to put this all together. Thank you.
So I think that you all agree with me that this play was fantastic, do you?
Yeah.
Yes, that was the best. And with the script, we have to thank a few people who helped. So that's Nicolas Baptiste. We'll ask him to come forward so that you know who he is. Nicolas. Nicolas is also the director of acting. And also Claudio Samachetti. Can you come forward, please, Claudio? And Nicola and Claudio both helped Christian Caloux for producing this play.
Nicola, would you step forward? Nicola Baptiste, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. And now we come to the man himself. He's a man that has put this all together. He's standing right in front of you. Christian Caloux, could you please put your hands together for our producer?
So, do we want Christian to say a few words about this play? Yes, I think we want him.
I thank you all, everyone, to support us, and I hope for the next time we are going to show the second part of the show, and we'll do again some ball just for support all the motion students in Melbourne and some poor people in Mauritius who are going to help them do. But we have to keep going with our culture, with non-difference of color or religion. Proud and very proud to be here in Australia. And we are going to keep going like that. Years and years and years and years. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
And we're all looking forward to the next second part. And I've recognized some of the new students who have just come, and a lot of young people and not so young people. So thank you for keeping the culture alive. So now, ladies and gentlemen, while the crew leaves the floor, we're going to invite you for some dancing again. So DJ Stefan, more music, please.
Ramasse ses enfants, ramasse ses enfants.
you guys on the dance floor, you're invited to come onto the dance floor and let's live it up with the cast and the crew. Thank you. I'm